Members, I once again welcome you into this new lesson. Let me hope that the first lessons were fair and good for you in terms of learning Runyankore Luchiga. And I have hope and believe that by the end of this session of learning Runyankore Luchiga, everybody shall benefit from it. Specifically today, we are going to look at syllables with three letters. Last time, members, we looked at syllables with two letters and words formed from the syllables with two letters. And today, we are learning a new thing. It is also, they are also syllables, but the difference is the number of letters they have per syllable. Today we are looking at syllables with three letters. In Runyankore Luchiga, it is Enjinga Zenguta Ishat. Enjinga Zenyuguta Ishatu, that is the local language, which means syllables with three letters. Runyankore Luchiga will call it Enjinga Zenyuguta Ishatu. The word Enjinga represents the word syllables. Zenyuguta, that is the number of letters. Now, Ishatu represents number three. Yes, last time we looked at syllables with three letters, and now we are looking at syllables with three letters, and below are the sample of such syllables. We shall begin with a syllable that has letter B. And when we are forming these syllables, members, I want you to be aware that vowel letters are not appearing in formation of syllables. Instead, they are used to accompany the consonant letters to form sounds of the syllables in words of Runyankore Luchiga. That's why we are not beginning with the A above. Instead, we are beginning with the letter B according to the order of alphabet letters. We are beginning with the letter B. We have letter C, and when we are beginning with this, when we are forming these syllables, members of three letters, the letter B is accompanied by letter M behind it, and letter A in front to produce a sound. I told you before that vowels are the ones that produce sounds in words of Runyankore Luchiga, as well as the syllables as we are looking at them. And the pronunciation now becomes Mba. The syllable of the two letters we made last time, we formed the syllable called Ba. But this time we are adding letter M behind the other syllable of Ba, to form another syllable of three letters called Mba, and we shall keep on looking on words in Runyankore Luchiga where these syllables appear in three letters. We have Mba, Mbe, Mbi, Mbo, Mbu. We have Mka, Mcha, sorry, Mche, Mchi, Mcho, Mchu. These are the syllables of three letters where we will use the consonant letter C, and it is accompanied by letter M behind it to form that sound. Cha, Mche, Mchi, Mcho, Mchu. The word in cha, it is coming up because of the letter M behind the syllable.
chart.
Members, before we move further, let me draw a line in this syllabus. We miss vowel letters, that is A, A, E, O, U. In English, they are read as A, E, I, O, and U. Those syllables are not, those vowel letters, sorry, are not there on their own, only that they are used to accompany consonants form sounds. And the other letters missing in this case are letter H is not there, form syllables. Letter L, letter M, letter N, Q, R, W, and X. These letters are not appearing in this case because their sounds are how they are pronounced, produce a sound of vowel letters. That's why they are not appearing. For example, Q. In local language, we don't have that letter. We have a letter like R. We cannot form a syllable with three letters using R. We cannot form a syllable with three letters in Nyakoro Chiga using letters like M. The ones I've told you. Therefore, of course, I expected the question is, why are these letters missing in the formation of syllables? They are missed because their pronunciation comes with a sound of vowels. And yet vowels are used to produce sounds in syllables. We also have these syllables and they are pronounced as nda. This is nda. Last time we had da. But when we add N to make three letters in the syllable, it is read as nda. Nda. Nde. Ndi. Ndo. Ndu. Nda. Nde. Ndi. Ndo. Last time we had the syllables beginning with the letter F, where we had fa, fe, fi, fo, fu. But this time we are adding another letter N behind them to make a strong syllable with three letters, which are pronounced as follows. We have fa, when we add N, it becomes in fa, in fe, in fi. Mfo, mfu. That is the difference between the pronunciation of the two syllable and three syllable letters. We also had ga, ge, gi, go, gu in two syllable letters. And now when we make them three, the pronunciation now changes to nga, nge, ngi, ngo, ngu. I repeat. Nga, from ga now to nga. From ge to nge. Ngi, ngo, ngu. We also have, the other time we had ja. J, G, Jo, Jo. And this time we are making strong syllables of three letters where we change the pronunciation now to Nja, from Nja to Nja, Nje, Nji, Njo, Nju. Nja, Nje, Nji, Njo, Nju. We also had a syllables of letter K where we had Ka, Ke, Ki, Ko, and Ku. When we add letter pronunciation again it changes to from ka to mka, nke, nku, nka, nke, nki, nko, nku. We also had the syllables of letter P where we had the pa, pe, pi, po, and pu. When we add another letter behind them, it becomes a strong pronounced syllable, and here we are not adding the letter N. We are adding the letter M. We add the letter M on syllables like ba, a, b, bo, syllables with the letter ba, b, sorry, and the syllables with the letter p. We cannot now say mpa in this nature adding the letter a. If it does not make sense or clear pronunciation of the words in Runyankore Ruchiga, we rather put the letter m to make the language correct. In terms of syllables, we don't use letter N on syllables beginning with letter P and letter B. These are the two letters where we don't add N, instead we put letter P and it becomes fine in Runyankore Ruchiga. I don't know in other languages, but in Runyankore Ruchiga it appears in such a nature. Therefore, we shall read them as mpa, mpe, mpi, mpo, mpu. Mpa, mpe, mpi, mpo, mpu. These are the syllables beginning with letter M. Let us look at other syllables. We have, last time we had sa, se, si, so, and su. And now when we add letter N behind those syllables I have marked the way we saw them last in the previous lesson, now the pronunciation of the syllable changes from sa to msa, from se to mse, from si to msi, from so to so, and lastly from su to msu. Nsa, nse, nsi, nso, msu. Last time we looked at this syllables beginning with letter T, where we had ta, te, ti, to, tu. They also change in the pronunciation and they become ta after adding letter N behind those syllables. This becomes in te, nti, nto, ntu. Nta, nte, nti, nto, ntu. We also had these syllables beginning with letter T where we had va, ve, vi, vo, vu. And when we add another letter, the pronunciation also changes from va to va, ve to ve, vi to vi, vo to vo, vu to vu. Mva, mve, mvi, mvo, mvu. We also had another syllable of two letters beginning with letter Y, and we had ya, ye, yi, yo, and you. And they also change in the pronunciation once they become silent letters in the syllable and they are read as follows. We have nya from ya to nya, nye, nyi, nyo, nyu. Nya, nye, nyi,
is letter Z, which is the last alphabet letter, where we had Z, 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 Zo, and Zo. And when we add another letter, which is N, to become 3 in a syllable, they automatically change the pronunciation. We don't read them the way we have been reading them. This is a becomes in Z, Z becomes in Z, Z becomes in Z, Zo becomes in Zo, and Zo becomes in Zo. Nze, Nzi, Nzo, Nzu. Members, I want you to learn how to form these syllables in my absence, and this shall help you or guide you in my absence when forming syllable letters. We have four syllables from the letters below. In Mnyankole Chiga, it means kola, enjinga, zekigambo, bishatu. Kola enjinga zekigambo bishatu. Form syllables from the letters below. We have this letter N. It has branches. The first branch has letter T and the last branch has letter A. And we shall form a syllable now called Dita, where we get A, which is here, plus letter T, plus letter A at the end, and it becomes a syllable Ta. Members, you will also help me form syllables from these letters I have drawn there, add the branches together and form good and pronounced syllables in Mnyankole Chiga. I thank you for listening, and I hope to do better. I hope that we will do better in the next lesson.